These are my materials for my Bisa Butler portrait exhibit inspired mail art set. I have my Bisa Butler postcards that I bought at the gift shop, which, amazing, they came inside of an envelope. So I'm gonna show you how to carefully open an envelope that's been sealed so that you can reuse it. I've got my visitor guides. It only took a couple. You don't need a ton. I've got my bag that my buying my postcards came in. We'll see if I use this or not, but so this is exactly big enough for a few stamps and an address, and it is half an inch, so that means it can be put in a blue mailbox. So this will be an experiment that I send out with like a pencil to a friend. I'm gonna keep a pencil or two because these pencils are cool. Yeah. And then I just pulled out some blank envelopes from my collection to build on top of if I need them. But yeah, some complimentary tapes. But I'm just gonna get started, sort of talk you through my process. All right, so I told you we're gonna open up this envelope like I did this one. So yeah, I can just use this envelope. Just stick a lovely label on it, mail it out to a friend. It's set and ready to go. Like, it requires nothing else. Probably put some tape on it. We'll show you that. But yeah, first things first, let's deconstruct. What I have here is a letter opener that a friend gave me. And I'm just trying to slide it under. Yeah, there you go. So yeah, you just try and work it underneath where it's been sealed. If you run into struggles, sometimes you can try steaming them open. Most of the time, it's not an issue. So those postcards will go in my postcard pile. These two envelopes are ready to go. So this is just stapled. So if I had a staple remover, I could just use a staple remover. But weirdly, I don't. So I'm just using my letter opener to pry up those staples so that I have a nice flat piece of paper to work with. Fingernails are good for this. If you don't have fingernails, you can pry it up using your letter opener. So yeah, so now I have a couple of sheets to work with here. And while these ones don't have any of the Bisa Butler stuff on them, I think you can still use them. Like, it's still evidence of your visit. It's still, like, it's gonna pertain to what you're telling people in the letter, and I think that's super cool. Like, that's super fun. So those are all ready. And the thing about bags is that they're essentially already an envelope. All you have to do is fold it over and tape it shut, and you're good. This one's a little big, so I probably will deconstruct it and cut an envelope out of it. But if this bag was, say, this size, it'd be all set. You just fold your letter up, fold this over, tape it, you're good. Yeah. again, if you want to deconstruct a bag, you look for them seams. Is just white, so it's not gonna matter if I just cut it. Sometimes a bag is patterned and you want to take care to preserve the pattern when you open it. But you can just cut this. Yeah. Okay. Alright, so I know that this is the front of my envelope. And I know I want Art Institute of Chicago to show up on the front of the envelope. It's sort of a question of the best placement. You also have to remember that you are addressing it as well. Maybe if it's coming down vertically. Yeah. I'll run into less of a loss issue when I design around it. This is just an envelope template that I made out of some chipboard. There is already a video of me available on the internet making these. I like how this uses material that would otherwise be thrown away. I like how it corresponds with the journey that I took. It's just you could even use like this bag as stationery if you wanted. Could have opened it up and flattened it out and written a letter on the bag. There's all kinds of ways of using what you have. And increasing the meaning of that thing at the same time. All right, yeah, that worked out good. Happy with that. You're set. All right. So again, I know that my envelope is going to be in a certain place, and I want to be able to really champion like this bit. So one of these I'm gonna make into an envelope, one of these I'm actually just gonna cut pieces from. Yeah, maybe a smaller envelope will be better. Be able to manipulate the space. See that I'm overhanging a little bit over here? That shouldn't be an issue. Maybe I want to do it like this. Yeah, we'll see how that goes. I just don't want to cut off anybody's head. Right, yeah, so I'm overhanging this way and this way, but because of the way the templates are designed, things are overlapping, so it should be made up for otherwise. I'll even cut this one down a little further, so it'll have a little more space. Nice thing about using a freeform template as opposed to like an envelope maker. I've seen a scrapbooking companies put out like a crazy envelope punching board, which I mean looks cool, but you have to always have this right size piece of paper to use it. You don't have the freedom to really manipulate that paper. If you were making a ton of envelopes, then yeah, great. But I'm not, I'm making this one. We'll be fine. Yeah. And so that maximized the art on the front of the envelope, the way we positioned the template before we cut it. I got a little sticky and a space where I don't want sticky. This is a rubber cement eraser. It works really well for taking off glue tape. Yeah. All gone. No more sticky. Alright, so that's all set. These are great scraps. Gonna hang on to those. These are also good scraps. Snag some stamp scissors. These are just Fiskars post paper edgers stamp design. And with these novelty cut scissors, if you ever go all the way to the edge with them, they'll give you a weird, like, flat space. It's So I'm often trying to not cut all the way. There's a nice useful scrap. See, I'm only going that far. I didn't do the last two teeth. Ones, you know, I'm just gonna try and snag some of that fun map in the middle. Actually two pieces that I cut at once. I like this side better than this side, so this will be the interior. One of my favorite pieces that the Art Institute sometimes has on display is called Silver Beach. I do not remember the name of the artist at the moment. I will, you know, throw it up on screen. But Silver Beach is a contemporary piece in which there are just these pieces of large paper, and some of it has been printed with silver ink. The whole idea is that people will take a sheet of paper when they enter the gallery, and so the stack of paper ebbs and flows like the tide. And also the paper is just really nice. And I've definitely made very nice envelopes out of it. All right, I got a little sticky right there. Gone. second verse almost the same as the first. Do it like that, because I know I like the look of that part of the museum map, so if I can maximize it on the envelope, I will. Might be some potential for use in these scraps, so we will keep them about. Bisa Butler's work is all about these layers of fabric that have been quilted, and I could certainly be doing something to more mimic that look in these, but I have learned that fabric really isn't my thing. So I don't have much in mustache, so paper it is. I want colorful labels. One of the things I really loved, though, was all of the color that she had going on in her stuff. One of the things I really loved about her work is that she uses these translucent mesh fabrics to play with light and shade in her pieces. And that's just phenomenal. So you get a little bit of that in the, like with washi tape, how you can work up layers of transparency. These are just scraps I had for making this envelope. And like this edge is a little awkward, but I know that when I place my stamp, it's gonna cover that up. And these might not be done. Like these are at a level where I can move on to something else, but we might work more on top of these, more tape, stickers, markers, that sort of thing. Where I sort of keep a rhythm going. See, this is an example of what I was saying about, you know, just using all the stuff. I like to use the outside edges of my labels. Oh, and fun fact, this stuff, this is called selvage. I loved this, the I and the okay. I'm trying not to cover that up. See, that one's done. Those ones don't need a lot. And this is a pre-printed envelope that I had. I think it's a Muglia envelope from one of their cards. But I thought it really worked well with what I have going on here, so pulled that one out as a base. It's always a question of, like, do I rip or do I cut? I think these are cut. Divide these two. because this one is fussy cut, I'm gonna use glue stick. I've got it on a piece of scrap paper here, and you'll see I'm taking the glue all the way out over the edges. Because part of this is flat, I'll use glue tape on that part. See, this is one of those scraps from cutting out my envelope. So I'm after this strip. I can honestly just use scissors on that one. Use all your tools. Use all the tools you have at your disposal. If you feel like you're too reliant on one tool, make yourself not use it. There are some days that I make envelopes without scissors at all. Make myself tear all the paper. So if you find yourself feeling like you're making the same thing over and over again, that's a good way to switch things up. Switch up your tool. I pull the tape out over the edges like that because I know I'm going to fold it under. Oop. I'm certain there are more disciplined ways to work that are a lot neater, that, like, you always put your washi tape back in the same spot, you always put your scissors back in the same spot, etc., and then you're not stuck looking for them like me, but that's not how I work at all. I'm gonna do a little cleanup though. Sometimes organizing your space allows you to like reassess what you haven't been using. And you're like, oh yeah, I have that. Probably not gonna use these white scraps of bag. Although, you totally could. Use them for label areas. But I have so much other paper scrap from the visitor guides that I'm just not hard up for the paper scrap right now. I'm probably not gonna use these ones. That's got potential. potential here. Might use that. Probably not that. Probably not these. Just a little less desk chaos. Again, I'm still trying to kind of play with the layering. Use those bright colors. Sometimes really thin areas of selvage can be tricky to put on, but if you leave them attached to the back for longer, you'll have more control over how to stick them on. And if you're really intensely concerned about things going on straight, you can get a grid background like me. Also, when you leave them attached to the stuff, that allows you to be like, oh, I wanted to put something behind that. Voilà. This pair of legs was my favorite part in this particular piece. They were, you cannot get a sense of how many layers that is from this reproduction at all. You have to go see it.
Thank you.
quiet because what I'm trying to achieve here. Oh, doesn't matter because it didn't work out. I was trying to put it both on top and behind. I mean, and I did, but you have to go to the back of the envelope to see what happened. All right, so I don't want this one to show on the front of the envelope, so I'm just gonna trim that. Sometimes if you're quick about it. You can fix a mistake. Sometimes you just have to live with it, and you have to learn to make an upside down image work. My sticky bit has gone a little to the opening of the flap, so I'm just gonna cut it and fold it over. Thank you. So that's all the envelopes that I had pulled out to make, which, I mean, that's a fair amount of envelopes from a couple of brochures in a bag. And plus, I still got this to deal with. I'll probably do my stuff on this side so I can cover up the price tag. And yeah, but it's just gonna, like, super easy. And then, like, it'll get a $2 stamp right there. With one pencil in it, it's not gonna be more than... I mean, the thing is it's gonna go at package rate. So, it's actually probably gonna need a $5 stamp. But yeah, what I plan to do is write my letter and wrap it around a pencil, shove it in there, and then mail it. And these two I plan to make art with. I might draw on the envelopes with them, who knows. Yeah, the Kohinoor magic color pencils are rad, and it's extra nice that, you know, they're a little souvenir. They say the Art Institute of Chicago on them. That's delightful. I didn't even know that when I bought them. I was just like, ooh, magic color pencils. Yeah, that's the plan with that. Yeah, so I hope you're inspired to take some things you might have saved from trips and not knowing what to do with. Maybe make some stuff. Or not, you know, you do you. People do their souvenirs differently. But this is how I do mine. Let's do a last look.